Hello friends, today I am going to show you how to multiply two numbers using Vedic mathematics tips. To start with, I'll take a simple example of squaring a two-digit number which ends with 5. So say for example 85. So what will be square of 85? This is how we multiply using regular technique. But using Vedic mathematics tips, I'll do it in a rather quick and easy method. So how I am going to do it with Vedic mathematics methods? When I have to multiply 85 into 85 or 85 square or any number which ends with 5 and I have to find square of that. So just write 25 in the right part because 25 is 5 into 5. Then take this 8 or the next digit 8. And what will be 8 plus 1? 9. So just multiply 8 into 9. That is 72. So the answer will be 7225. Same as we have done here. Now take an example, 75. 75 square will be 25 and on the left hand side 7 into 8, that is 56. So the answer will be 5625. So it is very easy as well as very quick method to find the squares. Now we'll see multiplication of two numbers. These numbers may not be same, so we are not going to find only squares. It can be any number. Only thing is, the number should be near to a particular base. Base is numbers like 10, 100, 1000, 10,000 and so on. That is the base. And any number can be below the base or above the base. So we have to find the nearest base to a given number. So take an example of 88 into 97. We'll go with the normal method. Right? So this is 6, 3, 5, 8. 8536. The first tip is, even if you are not applying any shortcut method or anything, don't just attack the problem when you see it. See the problem, observe the problem, then attack. Take an example here, 88 into 97, I have done this and I got the answer. But I'll not do it in this way. I'll do it in this way. Must be thinking, what is difference between 88 into 97 and 97 into 98? Answer is, I am avoiding one step of multiplication. 97 into 8, I have to do it only once. I don't have to do it twice. And answer will be same. But even this is a regular method. This is not Vedic method. Now, if I have to do it using Vedic method, how am I going to do it? 88 into 97. First of all, first step is find the base. So the base is 100. And this is 12 less than 100 and this is 3 less than 100 or 3 below 100 or 3 below the base and this is 12 below the base. Now few things you can observe here. So what is 88 minus 3? It's 85. 88 minus 3 is equals to 85 as well as 97 minus 12 is also 85. Right? Next thing is, if you see the answer, here it is giving you 36 and 36 is nothing but 12 into 3 or minus 12 into minus 3. Same way, 85 is 88 minus 3 or 97 minus 8, 12. So first of all, identify the base. Second, determine the difference and then go on. So again, answers will be divided into two parts. First part is actually multiplication of these differences, that is 12 into 3 here, and that will give you 36. Then you take any one of this cross operation, 88 minus 3 or 97 minus 12, both will give you 85 and the answer is 8536. And it's not a matter of chance, it is applicable for all such numbers. Say for example 93 into 96. So this is 4 less than 100 and this is 7 less than 100, right? By our method, 7 into 4, that is 28. And either you do 93 minus 4, you will get 89, or 96 minus 7, you will get 89. So answer should be 8928. I will verify this for you. 96, 8928. Now we will take another example. Say 89 into 89. So what is the difference here? Difference is 11 from 100, the nearest base. But if you do 11 into 11, you will get 121 and 89 minus 11 is 78. But the answer will not be this, because here there should be only two places, so or two digits. So this will be given to this, the left hand side, and it will become 7921. And this is not limited to only two digit numbers. I can even extend this. Say if I have to multiply 876 into 998, right? Can you imagine how long will it take with regular method? But see, how can we do it with Vedic tips or Vedic method? So 998 is nothing but 1000 minus 2, nearest base is 1000. Here the nearest base, the same base if we take, it will be 124. So the product will be 124 into 2, that is 248, and then 876 minus 2, that is 874, and the answer is 874248. 876 into 998 is 874248. So now I will show you how this method actually works. Take an example of the number which we have done first, two numbers which we have done first, 88 into 97. Okay. So in terms of nearest base, as we have seen, 88 is nothing but 100 minus 12, and 97 is nothing but 100 minus 3. So assume that this is 100, this is 12, this is 88, this side is 97, and this side is 3. I have labeled all the corners. So we have to find 88 into 97. That means this area, 88 into 97. This is the area which we have to find. This area is A, B, I, H. We have to find this area, A, B, I, H. Now, in terms of this square and rectangles here, how can I express this A, B, I, H? I can express this A, B, I, H as A, B, F, G. That is this square, this rectangle ABFG minus this portion, this entire portion, that is DEGH, plus this portion, that is DEFI, right? Now, why I have chosen this? Because to calculate area for ABFG is easy, because one side is 100. Same way, calculation of area DEGH is easy, because one side is 100, and DEFI is the one which involves the lesser numbers, that is 12 and 3. So what is this? This is actually 88 into 100, right? And this is 93 into 100, 12 into 3. If you'll notice, this is 88 100 minus 300 plus 36. Again, this is 8536. That is the area of this portion. Now, what is this 88 into 100? So, and that is the trick which you use here. If I don't take ABFG, instead of that, if I take ACDH, in that case, I'll have to subtract this portion, right? So, that case, it will be 97 into 100 minus 12 into 100. So, finally, what we are going to do is 100 into 88 minus 3, or 100 into 97 minus 12. So both are going to give you 8500. That is what which we use here. So here we say, and next is what? You add this 12 into 3, that is 36. So here we apply the same thing. Here it is minus 12 minus 3, 88 minus 3, or 97 minus 3, both are going to give you 85, and then 12 into 3, that is 36. So this is the logic behind this approach. So now the question comes, can it be done only for the numbers which are below, or which can be represented as a number below a given base? What to the numbers like 103, 104 and all? So the answer is yes, we can use it in these cases also. So we'll take the same example, 103 into 104. So obviously this is above the base by 3, and this is above the base by 12. So the answers will be same. Step 1, find the common base. Step 2, find the difference from the base. Step 3, divide your answers into two parts. Right part will be multiplication of these two. So 3 into 4 is 12. left part will be either this plus this or this plus this. Earlier we were doing 100, we were doing this minus this, right? Here we'll be doing this plus this. Why? Because there is plus sign there. So follow the sign. So 103 plus 4 will be 107, or 104 plus 3 will also be 107. So the answer will be 10712. We'll take another example. Say 1234 into 1003. So obviously this is plus 234 and this is plus 3. So answer will be 234 into 3, that will be the left hand side, right hand side. So that will be 702, and in the right hand side either this plus this or this plus this. Obviously I'll do this. So 1237, and the answer should be 1237702. Now we'll also see, can it be done for two numbers in which one number is above the base and another number is below the base. So for an example, take 124 into 98. This is 24 above and this is 2 below. So can we do it? Answer is yes, with some changes. So 24 into minus 2 is minus 48. In Vedic maths, we represent minus numbers as this. So 40, that represents this is minus 48. Next is 124 minus 2, 122. 98 plus 24 is also 128. So you can take any of this. The key is follow the sign. 98 plus 24 or 124 minus 22. So it will give you 122. Now we see that this 48 is negative. So I can't have a number with some part of it being positive and another part being negative. So if you see, this number is nothing but 122,000 minus, 122,000 minus 48. So this is what we have got, but this has a minus part and positive part also. So how to solve, or how to make all of them, or how to resolve this? So this minus 48, you can take one carry from here and it becomes 100. And 100 minus 48 is 52, and this side is 121, and the answer is 12152. 124 into 98 is 12152. Can we do only for bases like 100, 1000, 10,000? What will happen if I have a number like 213 into 203? So how to approach this problem? So obviously, if you see this 200 and 203, if I take 100 as base, or if I take 100 as base, so this is plus 113 and this is plus 103. This is not going to help us. So how are we going to do this? So instead of that, take the nearest base still as, say in this case 200, in this case also 200. So this is 13 above and this is 3 above this. Right part of this will be 13 into 3, that is 39. Left part of this will be 213 plus 3, or 203 plus 13. In both the cases, it will give you 216. Multiply the left part with the ratio of your two bases, that base 100 and base 200. So ratio is 2, so just multiply it by 2. So this will be 432 and 39. 4323. So this is how we do fast multiplication using Vedic mathematics. Now, does Vedic mathematics is only for doing fast calculations or multiplication, division, subtraction and all? Is the application of Vedic mathematics limited to only this calculation part? The answer is no. You can even solve complex problems of mathematics, from trigonometry, geometry, to even solving quadratic equations. So now I'll show you how to solve a quadratic equation using Vedic mathematics tips. You know that what is quadratic equation? It's an equation of the form of ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0, where a is not equals to 0. If a is equals to 0, it becomes a linear equation. And we know that the solution of this is done using two methods, either factorization. So one method is factorization. Another method is the formula, and the formula is roots equals to minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. And you must have observed, whenever you come to know that you cannot find factors, you cannot find the roots of this equation using factors, you lose half of your hope. And you have to come to this, when you come to know that, you have to use this formula. Vedic mathematics has a unique way to solve such equations. This part of equation is, or this part of solution is still important for us. This part of solution is called the discriminant. So first you have to find the discriminant. And the formula which we use here says that the discriminant is always equals to the differentiation or the differential of this expression. What is differential then? Differential is a different branch of mathematics which comes under calculus. So I'll not go into detail of finding differential, but I can say there, if you have an expression like this plus bx plus c, its differentiation will be denoted by f dash, and that is equals to 2ax plus b. So this is the differentiation. Vedic method of solving quadratic equation says that this differentiation is equals to discriminant. 2ax plus b is equals to root b square minus 4ac, or equals to root of discriminant. Okay, so now we'll take an example and see how to apply this method there. So take an example, 3x square plus 8x minus 3 equals to 0. This is the equation. D for this is b square minus 4ac, that is 64 minus 4 into 3 into minus 3. So that is 64 plus 36, that is 100. And this differential part is 2ax plus b, that means this is 6x plus 8. And apply the Vedic formula, that is 6x plus 8 is equals to root of discriminant, that is plus minus 10. So you have two equations, 6x plus 8 equals to 10 and 6x plus 8 equals to minus 10. So this will give you x equals to 3 and this will give you x equals to minus 3. So 3 and minus 3 are the solution. You can even solve simultaneous equations. There are some special type of simultaneous equations which you will have to observe. Say for example, this equation 3x plus 2y equals to 6 and 9x plus 5y equals to 18. So if you see this equation, you can see that the ratio between coefficients of x, that is 3 is to 9 or 1 is to 3, is equals to the ratio of the constant terms, that is here also 6 is to 18 or 1 is to 3. So 3 is to 19, 3 is to 9 is equals to 6 is to 18. In such case, if you find an equation like this, use the Vedic formula which says, if the coefficients are in a particular ratio, then the other terms, other variable will be equals to 0. So I can blindly say here that other term or other variable is y, and that is equals to 0. You can solve it with your normal method. So if you take these two equations, 3x plus 2y 6 and 9x plus 5y 10, so multiply first equation with 3, it will give you 9x plus 6y equals to 18, right? And then this minus this or this minus this will give you 6y minus 5y is y equals to 18 minus 18 equals to 0. But if you know that two coefficients and the constants are in same ratio, then just blindly put y equals to 0. If you put y equals to 0 in any of these equations, then obviously you will get 3x equals to 6 implies that x equals to 2. So you can solve the equations in a quick and easy way. We'll take another example, 2x minus 3 divided by 2x minus 5 equals to 4x minus 9 divided by 4x minus 7. Now here you will see the beauty of Vedic mathematics. So if you see these, the normal method will be this, 2x minus 3 into 4x minus 7 is equals to 4x minus 9 into 2x minus 5. So this side you will get 8x square plus 21 plus 2x into minus n minus 14 and minus 12, that is minus 26x is equals to 8x square minus 38x plus 45, right? So x square term gets cancelled and you will have 12x equals to 24, so x equals to 2. Now we'll see how to do it using Vedic method. Okay, so you have to first observe. As I told, you don't have to see, you have to observe. So if you see this equation here you will see that the sum of numerator and sum of denominator is same. So 2x plus 4x 6x minus 12, and denominator is, so this is numerator and denominator is 2x plus 4x 6x minus 5 minus 7 minus 12. So numerator equals to denominator. If that is the case, you can equate any one of them equals to 0 and you will get the solution of your problem. So 6x minus 12 is equals to 0, 6x equals to 12, x equals to 2. So no need to multiply two polynomials. There are many such short tricks, there are many such tips, there are many such methods in Vedic mathematics which will help you a lot, which will help you a lot in understanding the concepts of mathematics if you try to learn Vedic mathematics. So that's all for now. Thank you, and visit our website if you want to enroll to Vedic mathematics courses. Thank you.